Hi friends, welcome to our channel Farmer Geeks. Today we are going to let you know about bitter leaf farming, planting, health benefit, care, harvesting gear, marketing, etc. We also go through the different cultivation practices of bitter leaf crop for maximum profit. Bitter leaf is grown as a cash crop in southern parts of India, mostly in the states of Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Karnataka, Kerala and Tamil Nadu. Bitter leaf is also cultivated in Bihar, Assam, Madhya Pradesh, Orissa, Maharashtra, Tripura, Uttar Pradesh and West Bengal. Bitter leaf or pawn leaves have good export potential and India exports bitter leaves to the neighboring countries. Health benefits of bitter leaf. Chewing bitter leaves improves digestion. Bitter leaf prevents carcinogenesis in the oral cavity. Bitter leaf helps control bad breath. Bitter leaf may aid in treating gastric ulcers. It also helps in curing boils, aid in curing constipation. Climate required for bitter leaf plantation. Bitter leaf grows very well in tropical climates with high rainfall and shady places are the best for its vigorous growth. Bitter leaf or pan can be grown in a wide range of soils such as sandy, loam, heavy, clayey, loam. Supplementing the soil with the good organic matter results in best growth and higher yield. Soil should have good drainage as well. Land should be raised by 5 to 10 centimeters from the adjacent areas and soil should be prepared by 4 to 5 ploughings, providing proper drainage. Field bed of sizes 15 centimeter height and 30 centimeters wide are prepared. Soil should be sterilized thoroughly before planting the bitter leaf cuttings. Soil sterilization for planting. When the soil temperature rises during the months March to May, the soil is covered by polyethylene sheets in order to eradicate the inoculum of soil-borne pathogens. Applications of neem cake 0.5 tons per hectare or carbofuran at 1.5 kg per hectare plus carbofuran 0.75 kg per hectare is also preferred to minimize early soil nematodes population for new beetle plantation. However, carbofuran should not be recommended for preferred in established beetle plantations at any stage because a time gap of 65 to 75 days as the safe waiting period is mandatory between the harvesting of beetle leaves and the application. The best season for beetle leaf plantation. October month is best bitter leaf planting season under open system cultivation. The monsoon season is ideal for planting bitter leaves plants under closed system cultivation. However, planting season of bitter leaves varies from state to state in India. How to propagate bitter leaves? In bitter leaf propagation, stem cuttings having 3 to 5 nodules are used and these are planted in such a fashion that 2 to 3 nodes are buried in the soil. A single node cutting with a mother bitter leaf is also planted. Apical and middle portions cuttings of the bitter vine are used for planting. There are two types of bitter leaf cultivation is practiced in India. Open system cultivation using support plants or second one is closed system cultivation using rectangular structures artificial called barrages. Growing of support plant for natural support and shades plants of Moringa and Sabania and Erythrina are raised to provide support and shade. These support plants are sown in 45 to 60 cm sowed at least 45 days before planting the cuttings of bitter leaf. Rectangular structures are normally made on slightly slopy field near to the source of a watering at a higher level than the adjoining places. These rectangular structures are covered with using straw or coconut leaves or similar kind of material. How to grow betel leaves from cuttings? Basically, planting is done in rows and spacing between plants varies state to state. An average spacing of 75 cm to 100 cm. 42,000 to 75,000 cuttings are planted per hectare under open cultivation system, whereas 1 lakh to 1.25 lakh cuttings per hectare are sufficient in rectangular closed cultivation system. 1 month after the plantation of betel leaf, young shoots began appearing and these are trained along with the support and tied with them using jute fiber or banana fiber once in every 2 weeks or 2-3 weeks. Water requirements. Since betel vine needs high soil moisture content, frequent light watering is required. Depending upon the season of the crop, irrigation should be given on need basis and proper drainage should be maintained during the rainy season. Manures and fertilizers. Linseed cake, oilseed cake like castor cake, neem cake or sesame cake are supplemented as manures at 15 quintals per hectare. The cake is first soaked in water in big earthen pot for a week or so. Then this slurry is applied at frequently intervals of the crop. Oil cakes in powder form can be applied in monsoon seasons. Nitrogen at 200 kg per hectare per year as oil cakes or Farmad manure FMY should be applied. A dosage of 100 kg each of P2O5 and K2O per hectare per year is also preferred. The manures and fertilizers should be applied in 4 to 6 split doses at 2 to 3 months interval period. Yield. An average annual yield as good betel leaves crop is about 60 to 75 leaves per plant and 6 to 7 million leaves per hectare. This yield also depends upon cultivation methods and variety of betel leaves. Initial investment of betel leaf cultivation around rupees 1 to 2 lakhs per hectare in first year, 0.5 to 0.6 lakhs per hectare in subsequent years. Profit of rupees 0.5 to 1 lakh per hectare per year. These figures may vary due to several factors like location of the farm, agroclimatic conditions, variety of the betel leaves, current demand and supply, types of season, variations in prices of the leaves in the market. Fluctuations in betel leaves prices in the market may discourage farmers going for betel leaf farming. This can be overcome or safeguarded easily by involving a well-regulated marketing system relevant to the crop.